Yes, there is a position. So as we're rotating around the Smith chart, we can stop right here, and we're in the bottom half of the Smith chart, so the negative value, and we get minus J1.58 at this location. So we could subtract the two and get the distance, or the length, the shortest stub needs to be. So if we subtract 0.34 lambda minus 0.24 lambda, we'll get 0.09 lambda. And for an air-filled line at 300 megahertz, we can calculate that the wavelength is 1 meter, and so L, the length of the stub in meters, would be 9 centimeters. So if you're able to calculate or obtain the wavelength, you should give your answer in terms of meters. And so congratulations! We've figured out how to properly attach the new antenna to the Millennium Falcon so that all the power is delivered to the antenna. Get out your in-class project notebooks, and there's three things we're going to write down. One, describe how, since we only have some extra 70-ohm transmission line laying around, the easiest option for us is to connect a shorted stub of length 9 centimeters at a distance of, so here, easiest option is to use a shorted stub, and some values we calculated are L is equal to 9 centimeters, D is equal to 0.063 wavelengths. You could calculate, I guess that's actually 6.3 meters, centimeters. Give it in terms of meters. That's the distance where the stub is attached to the transmission line, so it's away from the load. So describe that first, and second, briefly describe how you can use the Smith chart to get D and L. And three, also mention the two other options we have, which is to connect an inductor or a capacitor, and one of these is more favorable than the other because one you have to rotate around further and it'd be further away from the load. And that's it.